Okay, guys. So what's up? Waffsticks here. And as you guys can see, I'm guessing, there's something different going on. It's not the usual deal. Not in a game. You guys see this little picture and it says, Admire, a Vixahut ship by the librarian game. This is a good little story that I read on Wattpad, and I thought I'd bring it to you guys. I thought this would be a nice little audiobook thing for the librarian gang. I asked if I could read some of her stories to you guys. So this is a new series coming for you guys. Wattpad fan fiction, or books in general. Wattpad books is what it's called, and this is the first one, and it is a Vixahut ship. Fan fiction. If you don't know what Vixahut, it is Vicstar123 and Pizza Hut. If you don't know who they are two Minecraft YouTubers that I personally like, and I know a lot of other people do too. So, please just listen. If you don't like this kind of stuff, click off the video, go watch some of my old ones. If you do want to see more of this, hit that like button, hit that subscribe button if you want to see more of me. See you guys later, and I'll see you guys, well, trying to sound like I'm doing my outro, but I'm really not. I'm going to start reading. Okay. So the first thing is, this is in Brandon's point of view. Most of it will be his point of view. I trudged through the march of that was... Okay, let me do this real quick. I trudged through the marsh that was the football field. It had been pouring only hours ago, but our coaches were not taking no for an answer. My shoes made slurping sounds with every step I took. If I stood for too long in a spot, I would start to sink into the quagmire. A couple of my teammates were cursing the coaches when they weren't listening, but I just ignored them. If I had a negative attitude, I would bring everyone down. That was what happened when you were the team captain, even when people didn't realize it. They looked up to you. I was the team captain for multiple reasons. One of them was because it was a vote the team made. And I was by far the most popular kid in school. But that reason stemmed from something else. Which was in fact that I was the quarterback and the best one the school had seen in years. Which honestly wasn't much considering we had never been that great. But man, was football a big thing in this town? I honestly didn't understand why it was so important, and honestly, I regretted trying out my freshman year. I didn't like how much attention it put on me. Before we discovered my hidden talent, I was just a dork that liked video games. Ever since my dad forced me onto the field that fateful day, I was destined for greatness, and no one would let me forget it. I sighed and scanned the field. I turned my gaze. Turned my gaze towards the sky, and I found it hard to believe. It had been storming only a few hours ago. The sky was bright blue, the same color as my eyes. I squinted as I looked around. I think I read somewhere that blue eyes are more sensitive to bright light. It seemed pretty true at the moment. As I looked across the field, I saw the cheerleaders practicing. A couple of them spotted me and waved one or two blown kisses my way. I waved back awkwardly. Most of them had flirted with me at one point or another, but I was never interested. Knew all they wanted was to say that they had slept with the quarterback, which was funny because no one could say that. I, oddly enough, was still a virgin. It wasn't that I hadn't had any opportunities, because I had. I was just never interested, but part of me had even wondered if I was asexual. I had never really been attracted to anyone before. I wasn't ready to take it that far yet. Though, I was snapped out of my thoughts when I heard my coach yelling at me. I sat and grabbed my helmet from where I had been carrying it under my arm and slipped it over my hair, preparing myself mentally for an absolute miserable practice. That was the prologue. Chapter 1. I pulled my helmet off my head, my hair still sticking to the inside of the from my sweat. My attempt to tame my hair failed, so I just accepted it and made my way to the locker room. My friend Rob was the wide receiver. I patted me on the back before ruffling my hair. Hey there, Petey, how you doing? Hey there, Petey, how you doing? You okay? I smiled despite my mood It wasn't a fake smile to help raise morale this time either. Hey there, Robin, I'm tired. Coach really knows how to wipe a guy out. I mean, 20 laps around the field on top of our normal routine? I think I'm going to die soon. He chuckled. Can't argue with that. I feel bad for the kid who got the rest of us in trouble. The guys aren't going to like him much now. I furrowed my eyebrows. That was a punishment for something? Who was it? Sophomore named Preston, Rob answered immediately. Sure hope the guys aren't too hard on him. Maybe I should watch out for him. I am one of the team captain, after all. Well, you go do that. I have weightlifting, right? So I gotta bounce. See you later? He nodded, so I patted his back and walked off in the opposite direction to get to the weight room on time. Another couple of hours of working out passed, and I made my way back to the gym. The slick floors of the school locker room reflected the dim lighting eerily. I always stayed late to train, so I was used to being the only student left at this point. I pulled my locker open to get my normal clothes out, but a slip of paper floated out. I obviously shoved it into the slits in the locker with haste. The edges were a little crumpled, but otherwise the thing was pretty much intact. After changing back into my clothes and shoving my workout clothes into my bag, I examined the paper more closely. It was full to the brim with neat, slanted handwriting. Anyways, this is honest. I like this book, personally. If you guys don't, I just give me some feedback. Go give the Librarian Gang some feedback, because a lot of good stories. I've read a couple of them, and I like them all so far. Can't wait to read more. Anyways, hi, I realize you probably haven't ever noticed me. I don't blame you, honestly, I'm pretty easy to miss, but I have noticed you. And I just thought I'd let you know that your eyes are the prettiest thing I've ever seen. They smile with you and are an obvious tell of when you're happy. I'm sorry if this is a little creepy. You just seemed upset today, and I wanted to try and cheer you up. It's a shame when you're sad. From me. I blushed furiously as I read the note. As one of the more popular guys at school, I had gotten plenty of notes asked me out in my day, but I never received anything this thoughtful. Whoever this was right. I had been upset today, and I had been tired, frustrated with everything, and this person had noticed. Rob was the only other person who had even thought to ask if I was all right. I turned the paper over in my hand, inspecting it as if I might find some hidden message telling me the sender. There was none. My curiosity was getting the best of me. I looked around the room like some amateur detective trying to find a clue as to who had left me this note, but I should have expected there was nothing there. It was just the locker room as it normally was. I really wanted to know who it was that sent it, because the note made me feel special. It made me feel giddy and lighthearted. I wasn't exactly sure why. I got compliments all the time from plenty of people. Who was it, this one that was getting to me? But whoever this mystery sender was, they certainly had me grinning like a fool. So, guys, I think that's the end. I will continue back to next week or tomorrow, depending on how much feedback I get on this story, on this first one, by probably tomorrow around 5-ish when I get out from school. I hope you guys like this, and make sure you go check out The Librarian Gang on Wattpad. Go check out my own Wattpad that I've been writing on. That's another reason I didn't upload yesterday. I was writing, I had homework to do, stuff like that. Just been busy, guys. Please deal. Also, I hope you guys like the just uploaded video that I uploaded, which was my new schedule, which will be, hope you guys go check that out. If you do, please leave a like and subscribe for more. Go check out The Librarian Gang and admire a Vixa Hut story. And don't forget to drop that like button down below if you want to see more Wattpad stories read. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button if you want to see more of me or hear more of me. And I'll see you guys in the next episode. Goodbye, guys.